another masterpiece from the artists of the, well, the Nature's artists who were performing in the Chibuku deposits at Mbezi Valley, Zimbabwe. Smoky amethyst, doubly terminated, little shots of hematite running through the ends. Not a very large crystal, but as one would expect from this deposit, very, very interesting, intricate form. Lots of mechanics and structural engineering taking place here. Let's go across like this. Now I'm going to turn it over. Is this a floater? I think not quite. There's the termination running across there. There was a little bit of a stem of sorts, so perhaps this was also the head of a scepter. Quite a lot of scepters from this deposit. Also, when we move it from side to side, now I don't expect to find in hydros in the sections where there's quite a lot of hematite, as you see in this one. But as you move the crystal from side to side under magnification and with a good lighting behind it, you may find moving gas cum water bubbles. They are quite abundant from this particular deposit. How do they compare to the Brandberg quartzes, the famous Brandberg quartz? Pretty well. Only thing is the intensity of color on these is usually a lot darker. And the patterning running through is mainly from the smoky quartz. And then in this case, the color concentration would be that of amethyst. So you'll have almost smoky quartz drawings running through this guy. All the way from Zimbabwe, Shangaan quartz. Let me just zoom in a little bit. This is clearly a little bit overexposed. Now, if you are interested in these quartzes, you would be well advised to watch the videos, because this gives you a totally different perspective. But in hand, that's the way to actually look at them. Very, very difficult to photograph.